Remember when sporty coupes were like all the rage? SUVs have really messed that up, haven't they? But regardless, Mercedes-Benz has updated its E-Class series, and I'm driving one of the beastly ones, which is the Merc AMG E53 4MATIC, if you will. And now, the E-Class range has been the best-selling model series in history for Mercedes-Benz. And some call it, you know, like the heart of the brand. And I kind of see why. But let's kick off with the most important thing to speak about when driving this car, and that is, of course, the engine. You've got a 3-litre turbocharged inline 6-cylinder under here. It's got an EQ boost as well, which means you get an extra 16 kilowatts of power and 250 newton meters of torque, which means that the 320 kilowatts and 520 newton meters becomes 336 kilowatts and 770 newton meters of torque. Both impressed by those performance numbers and my mathematical skills in that moment, let me tell you, because I ain't reading anything. That all came into my head. Okay, that's a lie. I totally rehearsed it because I'm so bad at maths. Of late, I've had some more sexist comments than usual on the old YouTube. So I thought, like, this is such a perfect song for that. Now, hang on, let me just slide up. I'm so sick of them coming after you again. Cause if I was a man, then I'd be the man. Power is sent to all four wheels via a 9-speed auto, which is super slick shifting, and it's all going to get you to 100 km per hour in just 4.4 seconds. It is a very refined, very punchy engine. As much as people like to call this or consider this to be sort of a baby AMG and maybe not as sort of beastly in itself, I disagree. It is super engaging to drive. It is a driver enthusiast car. It gives you all the AMG feels. And when you're sitting in this cabin, which, okay, so slight update, it's got little things like the AMG touches everywhere, you know, which just make you aware of the fact that you're driving something quite special. It's even got this new generation steering wheel, which is all kinds of fancy and high tech. I have to say, it's taken me a little bit of time to get used to. I was like pressing buttons, but it's actually like a scrolly thing and everything, but feels all very cool, very modern, very high tech, which is what this cabin is all about, really. These two screens here are just incredible. I think it makes it look and feel almost futuristic, but I love it because I think it just adds to the appeal of what this car is. For all of you who are very keen on a bit of oral pleasure, you just press the exhaust button here and away you go. Thing of beauty. So it might be close to 2 tons, but it feels really light, really agile. And the all-wheel drive system means that it's very tricky to come unstuck. There is no understeer to see here, people. Okay, you can toss this into corners, you can have a good old time. And although it's maybe a bit sort of cumbersome for corners, because it is still a big-ish car, man, it's still fun. And it's still quite spacious for a coupe. Okay, to be fair, baby seat stuff. Look, there's ISOFIX in there and everything, and I'm gonna try my best, but you know, like a two-door's not fun with a baby and trying to get them in and out. But that's not what this car is for, really, even though they've got those ISOFIXes for just, you know, the odd occasion, I would think. But you've got a boot of 425 litres, which is fab. It goes for around 1.6 million rand. When you consider that it doesn't really have any direct rivals, you're kind of looking at something quite special, like I say. But you could maybe look at something like an Audi RS5 Coupe, but that's quite a bit cheaper and it's obviously not as spacious. So again, it's sort of like in its league of its own. And I feel like this will continue being the heart of the brand, the whole E-Class range and everything. And I'm certain that this has already, I know that for sure, and will continue to find many a home in South Africa. It's quite bummed that my garage doesn't fit it. And I don't have 1.6 million rand. But if I did, then I'd be the man. I'd be the man. I'd be the man. Not so fun singing at robots. It's embarrassing.